Hello, it's Polish Paul VR. Welcome to the channel. We are here today to do some more PlayStation VR 2 news. We're gonna talk about another Fisherman's Tale, Real VR Fishing, a very fishy fame video, but also some other bits and bobs, like some another sale, PlayStation VR 2 sale numbers or something, whatever, I don't know. So many people posting about it, I have no clue. And some other bits and bobs, so let's get started. Let's get small. Thanks to everyone for supporting comment section. I do have still COVID, but feel lots better. It was like one and a half day when I felt proper crap, but now I feel lots better, so thanks. Sad news is I cannot reply to all the comments anymore since PSVR 2 come out. The views on the channel like picked up. I'm struggling to reply to everyone, but rest assured I'm trying to read all the comments and I will try to reply to everyone. But I cannot promise it's gonna be possible. Also, before I start talking, let me just give shout out to the patrons. They're scrolling down there at the bottom. Thanks a lot for support. I super appreciate it. If you want to be a patron, go to patreon.com/polishpolvr. From just $1, you can become a patron. Anyway, and have some, you know, some extra behind the scene posts. Okay, let's do it. So here we are. This is Real VR Fishing. You know that fishing game. I don't know. You should know it if you watch the channel. If not, we look at some pictures, but anyway. So basically they ask about other version like Pico and stuff like that. And what they're saying is, sure, our end goal is to make sure that everyone can enjoy our content, regardless of platform, and we're working on a number of things to make that happen. Because of course, oh God, I'm still getting a bit out of breath. Because of course, PSVR, two versions, they've been talking about that other day as well. So this is your fishing game, what kind of uses those realistic environments. Now I'm trying to scroll through something to show you something, but the developer got a lot of GIFs here. Yes, okay, so anyway, that's the, is that the roadmap? Oh, that's from ages ago, is it? Oh no, from March. So there are updates, different like environments and stuff. Of course, it's out on Quest now. Oh, there you go. This is one. Where do you fish this weekend? How about, you know, they're using those realistic environments, kind of like the developers of Kayak VR. You know, they're trying to have this type of game. There you go. Finally found something. Like, looking so cool. That's why this game, let's say, it's so wanted by everyone. So now it's out on Quest, I think, or something like that. But thing is, with PlayStation VR 2 is that it's got no fishing games at all. So the first person, oh nice music kicked in, I better switch it off because I might get copyright strike. So the first person to release the fishing game on PSVR 2 definitely gonna be like in chance of the biggest recognition, let's say. Okay, so that's the news about Real VR Fishing. But let's move on maybe to something else, and another fishy business here, which is another Fisherman's Tale. The trophies popped up, so the game is just around the corner. It kind of gives you the idea of the size of the game. Not many trophies, not platinum though. So I think it's got 1, 2, 3, 5 chapters, so might be a bit longer maybe than the first one, I don't know. Coming of course from the studio, what's done that Mask Maker game as well. They always use like a interesting mechanics in their games. So yeah, it's gonna be interesting to see how another Fisherman's Tale gonna turn up. But I'm assuming it's gonna be good game. All their games, the studio who done them games, all their games are always good. And of course they're gonna be published by Vertigo Games here, which is they got into publishing, but also they developing, you know, Arizona Sunshine and After the Fall, but Inner Space VR is the developer of that one. Okay, what's next? Oh yes, let me play you some stuff. Here we are. Trailer for Puzzling Places. Now I'll be pausing this trailer because it's me reacting to it. A nice fountain. So if you don't know, I'm the latest fan of the game. I never played it until I did. And I only played it because the developer sent me the code and I absolutely, really like this game. So this is a fountain, what they add in. Okay, some kind of another, what you call those things, I don't know, building, let's call it like that. I was thinking it's got like a basketball court down there, whatever. Oh yes, see, nice train, very nice. Okay, what else we got? So this pack is a variety pack, monthly pack. Oh, a lighthouse, in the sea. Nice, okay, and this is some sort of another lighthouse. Can we are just looking lighthouse? I don't know, but be interesting to make it. So this is, oh, look at that, I'm a chef. I'm gonna enjoy. It's all tea, salad, chicken, spice, what? Fish spice, what? What are those spices? Give me the names. Wow, that's pretty cool. Okay, so that's your monthly pack number 12. Oh, yeah. So you can buy it now. It's out now. So looking really nice. Okay. What else is out now is here. I love the art for this game, just a chicken. So this is Across the Valley. $19.99 or 15 quid, as you can see, in UK. Out now. This is coming from the developers of Conrad the Kitten, Fusion Play. So this is your like a farming game, farming simulator, let's say, but with those, let's say, very cartoonish looking graphics. Now I stopped playing every game possible, so I play what I want now, just to, you know, manage my time better, let's say. But I got nothing against this game. I'm not gonna play, I'm not gonna buy it, like, but if you want, you can, especially if you want, like, non-violent games. You get to, you know, you get to plant some plants, water them, watch them grow, you know, look after your crops, look after your animals, sell your plants, tomatoes, whatever. Yeah, nice things like that. So this is Across the Valley. Proper farming simulator would be nice one day. Okay, anyway, this is another strange thing. So this is another analysis. Some crucial updates on the sales. Shipments of AR VR headsets devices. So he's apparently analyzing everything and apparently he's good. I don't know. There's so many people now. So this is different numbers that one we've had other day. What we've had other day when they released, you know, that that 270 numbers, 1000 something. How do they know? That's what I want to know. So, crucial updates on the sale shipments of AR VR devices. Sony has cut its 2023 production plan for the PSVR 2 by about 20%. Now, how do they know it? Where does their numbers come from? That's what I want to know. The product life cycle shipment for Meta Quest Pro is only around 300,000 units. Pico, China's largest AR/VR headset brand, shipments in 2023 were more than 40% lower than expected. Now listen, it's all doom and gloom. Now about Sony, it might not be even true. Now I wouldn't be surprised if Meta Quest Pro not selling that great because it's super expensive. What is it, like $1,500 or something? Pff. Now Pico, even though they're trying to be alternative to Quest and that, you know, this is... Quest is the headset coming from Facebook, Pico is the headset coming from TikTok. You know, they know the companies what many people wants to trust anyway. I mean, I don't care, you know, I've got Facebook, like, I'm not on TikTok, just don't have time to put my videos on TikTok, but I know there's not many people trusting those companies as well. I don't know, there is currently insufficient evidence to suggest that AR/VR headset can become the next star production in consumer electronics. Apple announcement, I don't know why people thinking Apple is something awesome, it's gonna be just another headset, is it? Event is likely the last hope of convincing investor that AR/MR headset device could have a chance to be next star product in consumer electronics. The current market consensus may overestimate AR/VR headset devices' contribution to key component suppliers over the next few years, particularly in the optical related. I don't know what he's talking about. I don't know where he's got them numbers from. I have no idea. We're getting different people telling us about different numbers. I want to report on it because, of course, now when you go to look for some PSVR news, everyone comments on it, every publication. You know, those writing articles about it. I don't know, I don't care. I think PSVR 2 sold all right. We got some cool games, you know, like GT7 is great. I might play that today. You know, when you got COVID, you want to play game what you can sit down, which is GT7. Perfect excuse to rest and play games in VR. So I might play some of that tonight. You know, we've got Horizon, we've got Resident Evil Village. I don't know why it's all this doom and gloom lately, but anyway, I think it's all fine. Especially that only Sony know how much they sell, because their biggest markets, you can only buy it via the PlayStation Direct still, apart from Japan. Everywhere else is PlayStation Direct, you know, like their biggest market. So nobody knows their numbers, apart from Sony. Keep that in mind. Anyway, that's it for now. Big, big shout out to all the patrons. Thanks for watching. Like I said earlier, I might not be able to reply to all the comments anymore, but please do comment because I do read them. And for now, that's it. Bye, 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 bye.